President Trump announcing moments ago that he's granted a full pardon to his former national security advisor, Michael Flynn, who pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI. Also breaking, President-elect Joe Biden urging unity and calling on Americans to recommit to fighting the coronavirus pandemic. In a pre-Thanksgiving speech just a short time ago, he said, quote, "We're at war with the virus, not with one another," adding, "We're all in this together." The death toll in the U.S. has now climbed past 261,000 people as the country tops 12.7 million cases, and health experts fear those numbers will spike in the coming weeks, with one warning that tomorrow's Thanksgiving holiday is, quote, potentially the mother of all super spreader events. First, let's go straight to the White House and CNN White House correspondent Caitlin Collins. Caitlin, you're getting more information about the president's pardon of former National Security Advisor Michael Flynn.
Yeah, Jim, this was expected, but if you were here in the early days of the Trump administration, it's still surprising to see it in this way because, of course, Mike Flynn was only President Trump's national security advisor for about 24 days before he was fired for what the president said at the time was lying to Vice President Mike Pence, though, of course, we did later learn that he pleaded guilty twice to lying to the FBI about his contacts with the then Russian ambassador to the United States during that presidential transition period. Of course, the president announced on Twitter that he was firing Mike Flynn and then later replaced him. But Mike Flynn later tried to disavow that guilty plea, if you remember correctly. And then he wanted to get them to throw his case out. And what was the most shocking twist of all of this came this spring when the Justice Department tried to abandon its own case that it had brought against Flynn. Of course, that's something, Jim, that is still in legal limbo. But to see the president announcing on Twitter tonight that he is going to pardon Flynn is really part of this longstanding lobbying campaign that came on behalf of Flynn advocates urging the president to do so. And of course, it's coming as his time in office is also coming to a close.
And Caitlin, do you think this pardon is a sign the president does realize he's lost the election? He's saying that he wants to overturn the results, that the election was stolen from him, but he's acting like a president who's about to leave town.
That's exactly right. And that's how I saw this tweet coming from the president today, because, of course, Flynn is one of many that we could get. And by the president doing this, it's really his last business on the way out the door, realizing this could be his last chance to grant Mike Flynn and other people leniency. And so while today he was patched into this bizarre conference call, if you would call it that, with Rudy Giuliani and his other legal advisors who were in Pennsylvania with these Republican state lawmakers as they were meeting, pushing these baseless theories about election fraud that we've been hearing from the president ever since the night of the election. And so on that call, the president was on speakerphone. He was insisting this election was stolen from him and that the results would be overturned and that he was the winner, though, of course, we know he's not. And we see the government responding as if he's not, because the federal government is working on that transition of power right now. But if you look at this pardon that comes from the president, it does show that he realizes he's going to be on his way out in January.
And top Republican leaders and senior White House officials already chiming in to support the president's decision. CNN's Caitlin Collins will be talking about all of this. Stand by. Let's talk about more about all of this with former FBI Deputy Director and Acting Director Andrew McCabe, a CNN contributor, and CNN legal and national security analyst Kerry Cordero. And Caitlin Collins is also back with us as well. Andrew, I just want to ask you about, obviously, the breaking news right now, this pardon of Michael Flynn. As you know, Flynn pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI. We even have a tweet from the president, December 2nd, 2017. I had to fire General Flynn because he lied to the vice president and the FBI. He has pled guilty to those lies. It is a shame because his actions during the transition were lawful. There was nothing to hide. We should note here that tweet obviously refers to the transition of 2016 into 2017, not the transition that we're going through right now. To get past that mind-bending thought for a second, Andrew, what's your reaction to all of this?
Well, Jim, I have to say I'm not surprised. I think most people who've been watching this case closely expected this result, particularly as the Justice Department's bizarre and unprecedented strategy to abandon a case on the eve of sentencing, a case in which the defendant himself has pled guilty and then affirmed that guilty plea in court on two separate occasions. So DOJ tried to walk away from that prosecution in what was an inexplicable act. And I think as that seemed to be failing, the odds of General Flynn getting a pardon have gone up. But let me just add, Jim, The question of what General Flynn engaged in and how he handled trying to cover up that contact with the Russians is absolutely there's no question about what he did and what he said about it. He lied to the FBI agents when they interviewed him. He admitted to those lies in court. And everything that's come since then has really just been legal wrangling in an effort to avoid taking responsibility for that.
Oh, that's right. He lied about his conversations with the Russian ambassador at the time, Sergei Kislyak, during that transition from the Obama administration to the Trump administration. I've talked to senior administration officials who have acknowledged that they know that Michael Flynn lied about this at that time. I've written about it. Others have written about it. Carrie Cordero, let me ask you about this, because as both a lawyer and a national security expert, I would have to think that this is a stunning development. We haven't really seen something like this. The president pardoning people who were figures in an investigation that involved himself at one point.
Well, that's right, Jim. And the issue with these pardons is, first of all, I agree with Andy McCabe absolutely that it's not really a surprise, because the president has publicly talked about this case, has expressed his displeasure with this case, has expressed sympathies for Michael Flynn, as well as many of the other defendants in Special Counsel Mueller's investigation into interference in the 2016 election over a period of years. So I think this pardon was always going to happen. It's still, you know, unique to see it actually occur, but it was always going to happen. And it demonstrates that the president never did have any problem with the activity that Michael Flynn engaged in, never paid any attention to the fact that Michael Flynn actually did plead guilty. And then the attorney general's interference in this particular case by directing a review that then led to the Justice Department trying to back out of the prosecution altogether just was so unusual throughout the duration of the case. So I'm not surprised that we're here at this point. And frankly, between now and January 20th, I would expect more of these types of pardons and continuing to see the president unravel the work of the special counsel's investigation.
And Caitlin, I remember being there at the White House the night that Michael Flynn was fired and hanging out besides Sean Spicer's press secretary office. We were all waiting for this word to come down, and then it ultimately did. But as Carrie and Andrew were saying, I guess none of this is all of that surprising, as stunning as the news might be. But Caitlin, you were just saying a few moments ago, Flynn is now the first of what we expect to be many pardons from President Trump between now and Inauguration Day. And there's even talk of a potential attempt at a self-pardon. What do you think we should be expecting here in the coming weeks?
Yeah, whether or not the president will pardon himself is something that's been on everyone's mind, given the fact that he has told people privately he's worried about being investigated once he's out of office. But we have heard from sources who have spoken with President Trump as well that there could be pardons for other people as well. You could look for the George Papadopoulos, the Paul Manafort type figures that the president has not spared leniency yet. They could certainly be on that list. Jared Kushner's father is another one that several people have raised to me in recent days. Of course, the former CFO of the Trump Organization, Alan Weisselberg, his own attorney, Rudy Giuliani, who we know has people looking into him in New York. All of these things are potentially what could be weighing on the president as he is finding his last days in office. And what you were just saying there about, you know, this isn't really that shocking, because the president had been telegraphing for a while that he was going to pardon Mike Flynn. It's still really surprising when you talk to the top officials who worked here in the early days of this administration, who were here when Mike Flynn and all of that chaos was happening, you know, before all of the past 4 years had happened. And they're still stunned by it, because it wasn't just that Mike Flynn had lied to the vice president. It was the vice president. It was the chief of staff at the time, Reince Priebus, the press secretary, Sean Spicer, all of these people who were coming out and vouching for Mike Flynn at the time. He had lied to all of them. So it was this culture of distrust that was, you know, really kicked off the Trump administration, and of course, how the hirings here went over the last 4 years. So they're still a little taken aback that this is how this has ended up with a pardon for Mike Flynn.